Well, hello guys. I hope you're having an absolutely amazing day, and I am coming to you from the future. I am currently in Kyiv, Ukraine, here with my family, and I'm gonna get much more into that when we actually get to that point with my content, because as you guys saw in my last videos, I am still in Moscow and still have yet to go to St. Petersburg. But for today's video, I did just want to do something a little different, a little fun, and go through the differences that I have noticed between Canadians, being a Canadian for the last 23 years now, and Russians, which is, you know, a part of my heritage alongside Ukraine. At the end of the day, I do think that no matter where you're from, we as people have so many more similarities than differences, but at the same time, it's kind of fun to think about the different ways that people approach things in certain countries compared to others. And there is definitely some big differences between Canadians and Russians. So the number one, the top, the most obvious difference that I have noticed between Canadians and Russians is definitely how direct they are. I actually have a funny story to prove my point that happened literally the night that I got into Russia. I got into Novosibirsk really late at night, got to my hostel. Thankfully, everybody was still up because I personally feel really bad in hostels to ever have to like turn on the light when people are sleeping. But when it got to like 1:30 or so and most people had kind of, you know, retired, went to bed, I had the girl below me in the bunk bed sort of structure who was still reading. And for whatever reason, the light that she had on was just like so bright, it was coming up like straight through my bunk. So in a very Canadian polite sort of fashion, I kind of just whispered to her and was like, hey, excuse me, sorry to bother you, but you know, are you gonna go to bed anytime soon? You know, it's about like 2 a.m. And all she says to me is, I'm still reading. And I'm like, okay. Like, I didn't really know what to reply back to that because, like, my God, if somebody said that to me, if I knew I was still, you know, keeping somebody out, I would get out as quickly as possible, turn off the lights and be like, sorry, 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 sorry. But no, she just kept her light on. She kept reading for probably a good half hour or so. So yeah, that was that. And then with that same girl, I then had another confrontation where once again, it was like 1 a.m. and she comes into the room talking on her cell phone, like insanely loudly. There's people that were already trying to sleep. And that's when I went up to her once again and was like, hey, sorry to bother you. I really should stop apologizing. I go up to her and I'm like, hey, you know, like people are trying to sleep. And she snapped at me. She like puts down her phone and it was like, if you have something to say to me, don't run circles around it. Just say it directly. If you want me to leave the room, I will. And that's when I was like, okay, you know what? You are being a total, not gonna say the word right now, but you know what? You've got a point. And from now on, I will just tell you directly to turn off your damn light when it's after midnight and to get out of the room if people are sleeping. Fine. If that's how you wanna play, I can do that too. I can be direct. I can be blunt. So maybe the Russians are onto something. I don't know. Because with Canadians, sometimes it is this sort of like, you know, pandering, not being, you know, kind of just strong in yourself. And sometimes just gotta tell people how it is. Now, the second difference between Canadians and Russians on a whole, of course, not every individual, just as a whole, Canadians are far more liberal and Russians are much more conservative. It isn't a secret that in the West we do see quite a few negative things being said about Russia when it comes to LGBT sort of issues, minority rights, feminism, so to say. And of course there is a certain amount of truth to that in Russia, where there is far more persecution for, you know, being LGBT there than there is in Canada, where gay marriage has been legalized for so long, and overall I'd say most people are totally cool with gay people having the same rights as everybody else and showing their affection in public and being able to celebrate things like prides. And I actually did quite a few street interviews in Russia. Some of you guys may know that I work for a really awesome YouTube channel called Reporter Fry Media. I'll be linking them in the description, because that's when I actually went out on the streets and asked locals, asked strangers, you know, people that aren't related to me and probably have similar sort of opinions, what their thoughts were.
Как вот эти две главные вещи, которые мы слышим в России, что как здесь нельзя быть как гей или marijuana, такие вещи, это как в Канаде нормально, а здесь в России это нет.
Excuse me. Мы на эти вопросы не будем отвечать.
Не, нормально, нормально. Ну, я просто говорю, есть какие-то вещи в Канаде.
Вы понимаете, Россия, она большая страна. Если брать, в частности, Москву брать,
ага,
то там, я думаю, что на это уже она более уже такая. Ну а если брать Урал и туда,
ну,
дальше.
Ну да, маленькие места.
Ну, я имею в виду провинциальные города, типа наших, по отношению, если к Москве.
А, да?
Ну, у нас менталитет немножко к людям нетрадиционной ориентации.
Ну, да.
Такой это.
Какой возраст, вы бы сказали, здесь выходят замуж?
Раньше как-то вот и молоденькие выходили, а сейчас, mm-hmm, сейчас уже после 20 где-то уже выходит больше.
Ну, как
чем,
21, 25,
да,
или
раньше
как?
Же 18, 17, ага, уже все замуж покатили, а ага, сейчас уже как-то это осознанно делает.
Ага. А в какой возраст вы думаете, ну, как общий в Канаде, если вы думали?
Ну, я думаю, практически так же.
Да?
Да?
Нет.
Нет?
У нас, ну, женщины, может быть, 29-30,
да,
и мужчины, может быть, как 32.
А что-то я эти вопросы даже не думала.
Ага, угу, да, у нас даже больше и больше каждый год.
So I am, of course, going to link the full interviews that can be found on Reporterfy in the description. And I do hope you guys will subscribe to Reporterfy as well, because I actually release quite a bit of content for them. And I'm going to have so much more stuff coming up about Russia, where I actually did some like purely dating sort of episodes, because that's going to be our next topic here. And Russians definitely have a very different mentality when it comes to that. So make sure you guys stay tuned and subscribe to Reporterfy, because there is some good stuff coming up. So topic number three, dating. Being in a big metropolitan city like Toronto, especially where I live, we have a very busy, to put it slight, dating culture with a whole bunch of turnover and just a lot of things that I actually personally have come to the conclusion that I do not agree with. Because when it comes to the Western 50-50 equality sort of approach, I actually think, unpopular opinion, that women are actually getting the shit end of the stick. And I'm just done with it. Like, I'm not interested in a guy who wants to just like split everything that way, because that's not how I operate in a relationship. Like, I like to do a lot of very feminine sort of things that I know traditional men really appreciate, and that these guys that have this kind of mentality totally don't. So when I came to Russia, I was actually very pleasantly surprised about the attitude men had about dating and, you know, what their expectations were of women, which were actually very respectful, a lot more respectful than some of the crap that I have seen in the West. And it was honestly just so refreshing. So, of course, at the end of the day, dating preferences are a very personal thing, and there's pros and cons to all the different selections that there are available. But I will just say that if you do have a more traditional sort of mindset of romance being important, courtship being important, a emphasis on working towards long-term relationships, not just casual flings, and being honest and upfront, I would say go to Russia. Now, the fourth difference that I really noticed between the West and Russia is how people dress. Now, I'm not saying that Canadians are slobs. They're definitely not, and it really ranges to where you are in Canada. But as a whole, Russians take much better care of their appearance and what they wear in comparison to Canadians by a landslide. Now, yes, you guys are going to throw the examples of me of people in like Adidas track pants or girls in like really skanky clothing or something. Of course, they do have their crazy stereotypical sort of examples. But if you have actually been to a Russian city and spent a significant time in Russia, you will notice that on a whole, people really take care of the way they look, and it shows that they really put time and effort into their appearance. And I will say that I am absolutely guilty of leaving my house in sweatpants a lot, not brushing my hair, not washing my face, just literally, you know, going from a day full of editing to going out to dinner. Yes, I am a slob sometimes, I completely admit it, because that is totally normal in Canadian culture. Like when I went to school, people would literally come to school in their pajama bottoms. I kid you not. So just in general, I would say that the average Russian really puts some thought into the way they look. They try and upkeep their whole appearance to the best of their ability. Canadians, Americans, just gonna rope you in there because you're probably even worse than Canadians of putting in more effort, having a bit more self-respect into the way they look. Probably, you know, personal hygiene goes into there too, because the Russians definitely beat us in that. Now, the fifth difference that I noticed definitely has to do with religion. I'm sure that many of you probably know that in the West, in Canada in particular, we are very open-minded and liberal when it comes to people of different faiths having the freedom to, you know, practice whatever religion they want. And I think in general, we have a much higher population of people who are like atheist, who are spiritual, the million types of, you know, ways that that can be expressed. In Russia, I was actually quite surprised to see quite a few younger people, you know, kind of around my age or even younger, saying that, you know, they're going to have their kids baptized or going to, you know, a Sunday sort of service or at least going during the holidays. You wouldn't really find that as much in Canada, I don't think, unless you were in the really, really, really Christian sort of communities. Because in the West, I think there's definitely a very steep decline to people practicing organized religion, probably of every kind. And in Russia, it does seem that that is still a very prominent part of daily life and people of all ages. Now, the sixth topic that I wanted to touch on in this video has to do with education and your career and building a business. If you guys have been watching my videos for quite a while, you'll know that I actually didn't go to university and for what I wanted to do with my life did not see the point of going to university. The reason that I bring this up is because me having that mentality, which I think overall is much more prominent now in the West, me having a very Russian-Ukrainian mentality sort of family, that didn't fly well. More and more in the West, we are seeing people bypass university and being able to start their own successful businesses without a university degree and even work for companies that, you know, are really high up there without a university degree. There is just this sort of mentality that to me is outdated, that if you are an intelligent and educated person, you would have had to go to university. Like, you wouldn't believe how many looks I got in Russia when I would tell people that I didn't go to university. Like, they were honestly shocked. Now, the last and final topic that I wanted to touch on in this video is to answer a question that I think most people would assume they know the answer to, which is, who is nicer, Canadians or Russians? People who have been like world-renowned to be the nicest people in the entire world or close up there, or Russians who unfortunately do have this kind of reputation of being closed off, cold, and the bad guy sort of nation. In my personal opinion, I will actually say that it is very much a tie, but in very different ways. I really do believe that Canadians are incredibly nice and welcoming people, and I have always felt very at home in Canada, even when I first moved there as an immigrant, and I personally do love the values of being more liberal and being more accepting to people of different faiths, you know, different views of sexuality. I am all for that, and you know, pride myself in being a Canadian and being part of that kind of mentality. Now, Russians, on the other hand, having the slightly negative sort of reputation that they do, might actually have quite a bit to do with the way Hollywood has portrayed them. I have honestly been just shocked after doing this 3-month sort of odyssey, just how far people who did not know me, didn't owe me anything, didn't have anything in it for them, to completely go out of their way to help me or to just make my day better. As I mentioned in prior videos, I actually think that overall Russia is a fairly safe place, which is not something that we regularly hear in the West. And I think that overall that's because there is so much care from person to person. And even though people might seem a little bit, you know, closed off and they're not smiling the, you know, American, Canadian sort of smile and always like appearing happy, maybe they're just happy inside. Maybe they just show, you know, their happiness differently, and maybe they just help people in a less obvious but just as powerful sort of way. So that is it, guys. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it interesting. I would actually love to know what you thought in the comments down below on these different sorts of subjects. And of course, make sure you check out my full-length videos on Reporterfy, because back in the summer, I actually did quite a few street interviews in Toronto, and that was really interesting. And now I'm going to be having a lot more content come out about Russia and all the future destinations I do. So make sure you guys subscribe and check out to Reporterfy. I will put a link in the description. That is it. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and know that there is still so much more Russia content to come after this video. And I hope you guys are having an amazing day. Keep being your own kind of beautiful. And I will see you soon. Bye, guys.